evening, everyone. I am Mary LaRue, and I'm the Executive Director of the St. Paul Conservatory of Music. I am so delighted to welcome you all who are here in person. We are on the campus of Macalester College, and welcome also to those who are tuning in for our live stream. This is a really special concert tonight. I was just talking with the Jasper Quartet, and they were reflecting on how this is really a turning point in the history of this program. They were calculating the time that Tom Rosenberg met Karen Kim, and none of us could believe it was physically possible that it could have been almost 30 years ago, because of course we're all just teenagers, right? But it seems like that might be the case. When Karen was a young student, much like the students who we have in residence here this week, studying with the Jasper String Quartet and with Tom Rosenberg. So fast forward to 2019, when Tom started the Chamber Music Institute with Clea Galliano as Executive Director of the St. Paul Conservatory of Music. And of course, he right away invited the Jasper String Quartet to be a part of this program, and they have been an absolute core of the program ever since. And so the turning point that I referenced tonight is that this is the year that the Jasper String Quartet has taken the leadership of the program. And of course, it was beautiful as we were discussing and planning that it was a priority to them to welcome Tom back to play with them and to coach. So I don't know of any better example of chamber music than that, the desire to work together both on stage and behind the scenes. And I'm just so excited for everyone who's here, not only in the audience, but our students who are here for the week, to be learning from these wonderful artists. I want to say a big thank you to someone else who's off the stage today, though she's a wonderful pianist. Patty McPherson has made this program work, and there are a lot of logistics involved. So I'd just like to have a round of applause for Patty. Just a reminder that we all turn our cell phones onto silent or anything else that might make some noise. And I really just wish all of us a wonderful evening of music. I think we're all in for a treat. Thank you.
Before we start, you might want to know a little bit about what this thing is. This is an electric cello, and we're using it for this piece because it calls for a string bass, and I can simulate a string bass on this. I'll show you how in just a minute. But also, I just want to say, these are my really dear friends, and this is really awesome that they're here and that we're doing this together. And the quartet I've known for almost 18 years, and Karen for 25 years maybe, so this is great. Anyway, so here's what this sounds like, not electrified. Okay. This is what it sounds like electrified. Whoops, let's turn it on. Okay. And then, magic of this little gizmo. So I play bass. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for being here tonight. We're so thrilled and looking forward to this week with many of the people who are sitting in the back. Hello, all students, and please come to the concert on Friday also. Our next piece is by Derek Bermel. He is an American composer, and he wrote this piece as inspired by the novel Invisible Man by Ralph Ellison. And each of the three movements depicts a certain quality of the human voice. The first movement is entitled Harmonica and is inspired by harmonica blues. The second movement is Hymn Homily and is very inspired by gospel singing. And you'll notice a special technique of sort of scooping up to the notes, which Derek notates with quarter tones. And there's a lot of that notation that makes a very vocal effect. And the third movement is Hustle, which is inspired by the vocal inflections of hip hop. And I don't want to give away all of the special effects, but there are a few very cool ones to look out for. The quarter tones that give us sort of a lift in the middle of one of the movements. And there's also a very special effect in the last movements to look out for. So I hope you enjoy this. This is Intonations by Derek Bermel.
Thank you. Thank you.
final piece on our program is Florence Price's second string quartet in A minor. Florence Price was born in 1887 in Little Rock, Arkansas. She was extremely precocious. She graduated as valedictorian of her high school class at the age of 14, and then went on to study composition, piano pedagogy, and organ at the New England Conservatory. As an African-American woman, she faced many challenges in having her works performed, but she was recognized as a composer in her lifetime, and she had a premiere by the Chicago Symphony of her first symphony. The second string quartet is a wonderful work, which is just now being cemented as one of the great pieces of the string quartet literature. It was not published in her lifetime, but it is an epic work that really spans such a broad spectrum of emotions and experiences, and really showcases her ability to take us on unexpected twists and turns through the music. The first movement starts with this beautiful ostinato, or repeated figure, in the second violin that underpins this wonderful melody that emerges in the first violin that has spiritual origins. This movement then develops in a very late romantic style and is just a really wonderful and captivating journey. The second movement features another ostinato in the second violin, but this time is just two notes going back and forth. But through the magic of her writing, Florence Price is able to make every single measure sound unique and wonderful. The third movement is a juba. Juba is a dance that was created by enslaved people. They were not allowed to have instruments, and so they created this dance where they slapped and tapped on their bodies. And it was a precursor to the more familiar music that we know of ragtime and cakewalk. The last movement of this piece is a wonderful dramatic finale written in a rondo form, which means that the theme that it opens with comes back multiple times, and it is a really dramatic journey. We hope you are taken away by the piece, and here is Florence Price's second string quartet.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.